Welcome back to another guide video. Today we will be going over heavy weapons and not just blunt weapons, but we are also going over all types of axes in the game. So make sure you guys do stick around till the end so you guys can get all the information on how to do well with heavies. But before we get into the video, make sure you guys do what you did on the previous guide video and subscribe, because only 0.6% of you are subscribed and 99.4% of you are not subscribed that watch my videos. So yeah, without further ado, let's get it with the heavy guide. Okay guys, so the first thing you want to do with heavy is make sure you have a shield. And when you level up your heavy weapon, you see mine is 100. When you level up your heavy weapon, you want to make sure that you get the talents. Let me go over to the campfire real quick and see what the talent is called. It's for heavy weapons that allows you to one hand a heavy. So talents over here, and I will go to weapon, and what you want to get is one-handed training. You can now wield heavy weapons one-handed. This will allow you to equip the shield, and this is the only way you can equip the shield with a heavy. So now we got that basic out of the way, let's move on to how you should M1, or like what you want to be going for while playing heavy in 1v1s. When you're playing heavy, you want to make sure that when you're hitting an opponent that they've already hit, like they've missed an M1 so that you can get a hit in. And sometimes when you're hitting while they missed the M1, their M1 will still go in, but your M1 will do most of the time more damage than the M1 of whoever you're playing against. So let's spin on this guard and show you. So let's say he attacks. You want to roll that and then hit. That's basically what you want to do with heavy, is like psych your enemy out. And if you're Gale, you can even go a little further and not M2 like that. You want to jump up and then M2. They usually won't be in the same spot when you're M2ing. This is from a PvP perspective, but that's what you would want to do if you were trying to get your M2 in. Or M1 in. You want to make sure that they've hit from a distance first, because most people in a 1v1 PvP want to get the first hit in without any risk. That's why they use shattered, sometimes they use spears, and dagger users always use rapid slashes first. So if you're trying to M1, make sure that it's worth the M1 trade. You don't want to be M1ing and going against another heavy user and getting more damaged more than you are dealing damage. Like, let's say that I'm going against a Petra's Anchor, or I'm going against an enchanted Pale Morning that does more damage than me, I'm gonna be playing on the defensive side. When you're playing heavy, you always want to play on the defensive side, and you always want to have the best shield. So recommendation is to go 60 fortitude. So with that out of the way of how you should M1 and M2 with heavy, I mean, you guys already know it's self-explanatory. I just wanted to make sure to get my point of view out of how you should M1 and M2, because most of the time I'm going against heavy users and they are just aimlessly M1ing like this. They're just going ham, they're moving up, moving back, moving up, moving back, because they're just hoping to get a hit in. You should really be waiting for the hits, and you should be roll canceling and rolling so that you can get proper hidden without risking yourself getting. So now let's move on to what you want to get as a heavy. If you play Deepwoken, you already know as a heavy you want to go fortitude and strength. And the reason you want to go fortitude is obviously for the tankiness, and strength you want to go for the extra penetration. Now for me, I don't have to really go strength. That's why I don't have much in my strength slot, because this Pale Morning does basically as much as a Petra's Anchor's penetration and damage. So I don't really need to be putting much into strength, and you don't want to overly put into strength unless you have strong left and you want to get that doing more damage, or unless your build revolves around strength. From the previous Hero Blade video, I heard that there are some talents and strengths that can really mess someone up while you are doing, while you floor somebody into the wall. It can make their vision blurry, or it could also make them stun for like 1 or 2 whole seconds, letting you get 3 to 2 more M1s in. But yeah, unless that's the build you're going, then yeah, go strength. But if you're not going strength, make sure you go fortitude. I made this build thinking that I was just making this build for fun, and I didn't uncap my Gilbreath. Always uncap your Macho when you're going anything. Never leave your Macho uncapped. The reason why mine is uncapped is because I forgot. No, I didn't forget. I didn't have enough points to get it to 100, so I just decided not to uncap. As a heavy, you should uncap your Fortitude so that you can get the most health HP. When you're playing heavy, you're a tank. You're not going to get much hits in. Like, the Bane to heavies are basically daggers with the most fastest M1s. Daggers, Forgotten Gladiuses, Falconori. Because of their swing speed, they literally move faster than the M1 of a heavy can go. And that's where the mantras come in. Now, for the mantras, I've seen a lot of mantras being used as heavy. Rapid punches can be used to disrupt someone's M1 so that you can get a free M1 in. Like, you will punch them and then their M1 will stomp. You will cancel your rapid punches if possible and then go in for an M1 with your heavy weapon. The second most that I've seen is Pressure Blast, and they usually use that just to disrupt an enemy trying to gale lunge, shoulder bash, or anything like that. And these two moves, they're used so much, but no one has tried to use other moves to weave in other mantras. If you're going heavy, I believe the best mantra to really go with heavy is Gale. Ice, definitely Ice. Ice is broken because it slows the M1 speed of the opponent. And I want to say Shadow because it steals Ether. Probably Shadow, because if you have the status effects on them while using Shadow, you can deal so much damage. And Shadow already has its own, you know, Crypt Blade, so that's a plus. Now, let me talk about the types of heavy and axes, like the blunt and the axes, and how to play them. So, as you can see, I'm crazy slots. I have axe here. With axe, you don't really want to... Actually, I was going to say you don't want an M2, and yeah, you really don't want an M2 with axe because it doesn't do as much posture damage as a blunt will do. A blunt is guaranteed block break, and an axe, depending on if you have murmur or not, which I do have murmur, it's not maxed out yet, but depending on if you have murmur or not, you'll be able to block break them. But that is a what if you have a good enough axe to do enough damage to block break them. So if you're using an axe, you want to mainly go for your M1s and your run attacks. The reason why I say this is because, like, you can't really use axe as good as you can use blunt because there's a block break. So you're going to have to be playing from a distance and playing safe, if you know what I mean. The run attacks you want to be using as a surprise attack, maybe after a block break or after they've ran away to heal up, because that's a time where they're most disoriented and they don't know what to do next. They're like low health maybe, and if you got a couple swings in, because depending on what axe you're using, if you're using relic axe or if you're using Forces axe, you don't really want to be using Forces axe. Maybe a Forces blade will do you more better because of the damage. So let's say you're using an Forces blade and you do some M1s. Oh, oops, it's a blunt now. But let's say you do some M1s with the Enforcer's Blade, and you see that they're trying to heal or fall back. You can go in for M2, cancel it out, and then go in for a run attack like this. And make sure when you're doing run attacks, you're on the ground, you're grounded. You can jump if you want to, but it's more better if you just try to, if you do it on the ground, because it's more guaranteed as a run attack. So let me get rid of this crazy slots real quick. I thought I'd get the other heavy, which would be the sword, but since I didn't, let me talk about blunts, great hammers. For great hammers, your M2 is always a block break. You do not want to be losing any damage on that. Once you get an M2 in, or if you get a roll in, you want to go straight into an M2, depending on what weapon they are. If they are another heavy, you will be able to probably get away with this unless they parry it. Or if they are a medium or dagger, you might want to be more cautious of using your M2, because you can get damaged a lot while doing your M2, even though you get hyper armor, depending on what talent you get. Okay, finally, the perfect crazy slots. So with great swords, you want to make sure that you run attack. And I know it's annoying. I don't like it. Nobody likes run attacks. But honestly, it's your good source of damage. And don't try to just keep running attacking, because they will catch on and they will parry each run attack. When you run attack, run at them, maybe parry, maybe block, and then get some M2s, M1s in, so that you can mess them up mentally, you know, mix the mix-ins, and then you can continue run attacks when they're trying to go in for a Gale Lunge or they're trying to go in for a aerial step. Bam. Okay. I mean, yeah. I think I went over all of the weapons that Heavy has to offer, at least the basics. I'm not going to get into specific builds. Like I said in the beginning, it's good to go something that will make you extremely fast like Gale, or go something that'll make the opponent extremely slow like Ice. You can go Flame, but Flame, it has moves that are mainly damage based and they don't really give you upper hand within speed as a Heavy. Going Flame will make you lose the agility or the increased attack speed due to someone else's lowered parry in PvP. So yeah, I mean, you can go Flame and Shadow. You can also go Shadow because I haven't watched Shadow Heavy before. That's why I'm kind of like, what's happened? Like, I don't know how it is. One of my friends went Shadow Heavy. I still have his Pale Morning with me right here. He gave it to me to keep. But he went Shadow Heavy and it actually worked because it messed with the screen. It made your screen dark and also stole your ether. And you can't, you know, people in PvP spam, I mean, you probably don't know, that's why we're like watching this video, but most people in PvP spam their mantras with their M1s. So if you can steal their ether with Shadow Gun, if you can steal their ether, you can get an upper hand with, you know, your M1s. And that is basically with any person using Shadow, even though this is not a Shadow video. I'm just saying that Shadow is basically up to you if it's your playstyle. But my recommendation for Heavy would be either to be going Gale or to be going Ice. The other mantras you can go, but it's not as recommended because it doesn't give you an upper hand within PvP. Flame will just give you extra damage, which if you can do that, go ahead. And what's the other mantra? Shadow will give you... it'll give you more of a leg up if you're better with M1s and M2s. And parrying. But yeah, make sure you do have Mushroom Omelets equipped because that increases your damage by tenfold. Not literally, but it increases your damage so much that they'll be gone in seconds. But yeah, like I said, if you did enjoy this video, find it helpful, make sure to comment, like, and make sure you do subscribe, like I said in the beginning. And have a nice day, guys, and see you guys in the next video. Peace.